Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well. My name is Dev and welcome back in Pattern Craft. So guys, today we will going to create a new digital garment. But today I had decided to create digital garment not in cloth 3D. But today I'm going to try the Style3d software. If you're not aware about the Style3d, this is the another company who also have the 3D software for the fashion industry. So today I had decided to create the digital garment in the Style3d. I'm not aware how I'm going to work because I don't know how it works, but as I know, it is similar to the Clo3d. So if you know Clo3d well, then you can also work in the Style3d because most of the options and shortcuts are similar to the Clo3d. So let's get start this video. And again, I didn't decide what I'm going to create, so I have an idea what type of garment we will going to create. First of all, we will going to create a man outfit, and we will create a full outfit. We will going to create the cargo pant, over loose cargo pant, and I'm planning to create a puffer jacket with some head scarf. Okay, so let's get start. And before starting, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe it, and you can also follow us on Instagram. Okay, because I upload my projects or work in the Instagram, so if you will follow us on Instagram, it will be very helpful for me. So let's get start this video. So I had already installed the Style3d. So this is the Style3d software. This is the interface of the Style3d. It is almost similar to the Clo3d, and it's also work similar. Okay, so let me first of all activate. So activate the shortcut key notations. So it will be easy to identify which key I am pressing. Okay, so here it is visible which keys I am pressing. Okay, so let's get start this video. So guys, this is our 2D viewport and this is our 3D viewport. So first we will add avatar. So here are the options available for that avatar, and I will go to the library. Okay, and go to the avatars. I'm going to create the garment for the male outfit. So these are the different avatars available in the Style3d. First, let me add the avatar. As I already told you, I'm not familiar with the Style3d, but I will try how the software works, and it is similar to the Clo3d, or it's in advanced features. It have the advanced features compared to the Clo3d. So we will also compare between Clo3d and Style3d. So we had the avatar. Let's open the avatar. Okay, this is the Style3d avatar. I think this is the appearance. It will basically use to change the look. Okay, this one look much better. Let me also change the hairs. Oh, this Style3d also have with beard. This look much better. Okay, Other thing we will change is change the letter. Okay, so now let's get started. So everything we are going to create in the Style3d. So let's start with the bottom. Okay. So Q is for the selection tool. Okay. Let's start with the bottoms. Okay, so there is no option of unfold. Let me if you see the shortcuts, they are almost similar to the Clo3D. And these options are also similar to the Clo3D, like freeze, strengthen, solidify. So these are also similar to the Clo3D. This option is much better as compared to the Clo3D. I like this curve option, smooth curve option. Thank you. So guys, we had done this style, and now we only need to change the colors and the fabrics, which I will do the latter. Okay, now let me show you how it look like, how it's look like in the render view. In Style3d software, there are also some advantages for the background because they already have the by default many stages, scenes available, background scenes available in the Style3d. So you can choose any one, which one you like. Like this one, it look better for this one. So let's check how it look in the rendering. Let me add the background. So I think I need to adjust. Need to adjust the. Let me also change the pose. Go to avatar, main poses. Style3d, there are multiple options for the poses also. Let me try this one. And change the pose. I think we need to change the poses from the here. That is only for the download purpose. Okay, so with simulation on, we need to change the post. Now let's check how it looks. Okay, it's already showing. Multiple angles. Okay, I also need to change the size to same options. I will choose A4. Resolution will be 200. Maintain ratio, color, GPU, and the quality. Default noise only. Okay, that's check. Let's check how it looks in the render. After that, I will add the textures for the final render. Final render you can check out on my Instagram. I will upload the final render in my Instagram. So if you didn't follow yet, please follow me on the Instagram. We can also change the light. We can also change the light.